Hello, hello, and welcome to Hacks Find. My name is Adrien, and today I'm bringing you top 6 macOS applications that you must have on your Mac as a developer or a power user. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can install these applications and give you a bit more of tips on how to use them in your development. So let's get started. All right, guys, so number one on our list is Homebrew. And this application is great because it allows you to install applications that you normally find on Apple Store, but also allows you to install other frameworks for using in your development or you doing other activities as well on your Mac. So let's see how you can install this application, and I will show you a few more tips on how to use the Homebrew. All right, guys, so here I'm going to show you how you can quickly install this application, the Homebrew, on your Mac. And to start, you have to go on this website, so brew.sh, and you will find all the information that you need to install this application. So this is their official documentation. And from here, you can copy this install script here, and then if you go and then if you open your terminal application, so here I'll bring up my terminal, and from here you can just paste this this script and hit run. So I'm not going to run this because I've already installed, I have already brew installed on my application on my Mac, but what I can do, I can just run blue version just to see what I have here. And as you can see, I have 2.4, that's 16, the version. And also you can see what the you can see what revisions are out there on their Git repository. So this is a great tool, really, and I highly recommend that you install it. For example, if you want to install Firefox, you just have to type bluecast install here. You can do bluecast install Firefox, and this will go ahead and install your application. All right, so moving on number two on our list is Android 2. Let me show you how to install this application. All right, guys, so here I'm going to quickly show you how to install this Android 2 on your Mac. So first thing, you have to go on this macappstore.org/Android2. And here you will find the steps to install the application. So the steps are to first open your terminal and then install Homebrew on your Mac, and then run this Homebrew cast install Android 2. And the first thing you notice here is that it suggests to use Homebrew for the installation, but we have already installed Homebrew on our first step. So we don't need to install Homebrew again. All we need to do here is to open the terminal and then enter Homebrew cast install Android 2. And then run this, and it will install the application. So if I can quickly just show you. So if you hold command and space, it will open the spotlight, and then you can type in terminal. You can just do brewcast install Android 2, or you can just copy and paste that. All right, so I'm not going to hit enter because I have already installed this application. But once you have it installed, once you hit that, it's just going to go through a few scripts, and then it will install the application. If I go like Android tool. So once it's finished installing and you open your application, it will show you this, turn on USB debugging and plug in your Android device. So I don't have any Android device at the moment with me. However, if you would like to see how this application works, just ask me in the comments and I will make sure to do a follow-up tutorial on how to use this tool. Okay.
All right. So number three on our list is CopyClip. And I love this application because it allows you to store the history of your clipboard. So whenever you copy something, and it stores that so that when you go back and you want to see to do a paste somewhere else, then you will be able to find your clippings. So let me show you how to install this.
All right, so for our next application, CopyClip, it's also very easy to install. Just go on your Mac and open your Apple Store and then search for the CopyClip application and you should be able to see it. And once you're here, you should go on install. I have already installed this application, so I'm not going to install it again, but it's very simple. So just click install and then enter your password for your app, for your app store, of course, and then it will install the application. So if I, when I open the application, it shows this small icon here, and this is where your clippings of what you have copied will appear. So for example, let me go here. I can go on terminal and then say this is a test, and then I can just copy this, and as soon as I copy it, it should appear here, so you can see this is a test. All right, so to change the settings for this application, you have to go on the application and then hit preferences. And then from here, you can just set the number of elements you want to remember, and also how many elements you want to display on your icon here, when you click the icon here. And also you can select if you want to start the copy clip when your computer starts. So for example, if you restart the computer, this application can just start again as well. And also in the exceptions, this is where it is very helpful, because you can set what application you want to blacklist from saving the clipboard. So for example, if I don't want to copy anything from App Store, and also if I don't want to copy anything from Docker, for example, from Microsoft Word, from Siri. So you can just go through here and then select which applications you want to blacklist. And also you can read on about, so feel free to go ahead and check this out. And so once you're done, you can also clear the clipboard history. For example, for this one, this is a test, which I copied earlier. You can just click here on clear, and then your history is gone. And if you go back, there's no history here.
All right, let's jump on our number four. And on this, I'm bringing you Alfred for Mac.
All right, up to our next application, Alfred for Mac. This application is great. I mean, if you use Mac every day, you definitely have to get this application. Whether you're a developer, a designer, or just a normal user, you definitely need this application because it allows you to do a lot of things right on your fingertips. So to install this application, it's very easy. Just go on this website, alfredapp.com. And once you're here, you will find this download link. So you can hit download. And you can also buy some power package. So what this allows you to do is to get more features from this application. But if you just want to use like your everyday and don't have to do like crazy stuff, you can just use this free one and you should be able to get most of what you need. So few things you can do here is you can search and browse on your Mac. So just type in what you need and it will give you all the application and files. And you can also extend and automate from right from this application. So you can set up some of the tasks that you want to perform on your Mac and it will just run it through by its own. And you can control your music, so you can control iTunes. And they have also on this page here, like other things that you can do. And also, it's available through Apple Store. So if you go on your Apple Store, you type in Alfred For, you should be able to see this application and you can install it from here.
All right, on to number five is a simple GUI application client that allows you to manage your Git repositories and everything really that you can do on Git run from the simple GUI. And let's look at it.
So for our next application, Fork, which is a simple Git GUI client that you can use to manage your Git work. So you can download this application from their website. And so if you go on this website here, and they have a free version and also a paid version. So if you want to go ahead, you can just click here on download and it will download. And you can also choose whether you want a free or a paid version. So it's great because you can control your repositories right from the icon, as you can see here. And it has great features and it's very intuitive to use. So I will highly recommend this Git GUI, if you really want a simple and also easy to use application for managing your Git. And as you can see, I love how it shows the image diffs even up to the edits. So as you can see here, it shows, for example, this old image, and then it also shows you the new image that has been added or edited.
All right, so our last but not least application is Item 2, and this application is great. And if you use Terminal a lot, I highly recommend you to use Item 2 because it allows you to do a lot more on your command line. So let's look at it.
All right, guys, so our next application is Item 2, and this application is great. It is a terminal emulator that allows you to do a lot more than just your default terminal. And if you have been following along, you would see that my terminal looks different than what we had in the previous section of this video. And to get your terminal to look like this, you will have to have this application, Item 2, and also do some work, a little bit of work to get it to look like this. So you can see that I have some icons and I also have a good way to show where I'm currently, in which directory I'm in, and also the path to get there. And it also shows the Git branch that I'm on. And things to note here that you can do some easy text selection. You can split pane windows. You can do one page search. You can do some autocomplete. You can do mouseless copy, paste history, and also instant replay. So to rewind your sessions. And this application is amazing for that. So to download this application, you can go on item2.com and click this button here and it will download the application and you can install it from there. I'm not going to download it here because I've already installed this application. So please go ahead and do so here. But the easiest way to install it really is to go on Homebrew and just enter item two, and you will find the cask installation. Or cask installation. And here you can go on your terminal. So I would exit here. And you can enter brew cask install item two. And you can hit enter, and then you'll be able to install your application like that. So once you install the application, it will not automatically look like this. It will not have these icons and this path and these colors. You will have to do a little bit more of work to get it to look exactly like this. So if you want to configure your item 2 to look like this, I have a good guest here from Kevin Smets that you can follow along and configure your item 2 to look like this. So there is a default look here that you can configure, and also the power level 10k that you can also configure to have more detailed information on your terminal. So you can have time, and you can also configure how long the script or the command took. You can have icons and also show which Git repository you're on, and yeah, everything. So you can do also install, you can follow along to install item 2 and also install the or my zsh and or z shell, I should say, and also configure the power level 9 or 10k. So there's a lot of information here, and also how to configure the auto suggestions. And yeah, so please go ahead and download the application and then follow along to make it look like this. I will put the link to this gist in the description below, so make sure you check it out and have the application configured. If you would like me to do a tutorial on how to configure this item 2 to look just like this, so to go through these steps and also show you how you can use this item 2 to your own advantage, please let me know in the comments, and I will surely make sure to have a tutorial just on how to use this item 2 and also how to configure it to look like this.
All right, guys, so thank you so much for watching this video. These were my 6 favorite applications that I use in my everyday development work, and let me know in the comments what are your favorites that you use as well. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a big thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and as always, stay safe.